Hello friends, how are you doing? This strange world of flora is fraught with so many wonderful things. One of them is the spectacular world of zoophagous plants. But friends, be aware, because a few of such plants are though very beautiful in look, yet their nature is to kill. In this video of today's, we are going to talk about some such plants which are very attractive, but they are not ordinary plants, but predator ones. In other words, we can say that they are zoophagous plants. Now, maybe you are taking it for a joke, but let me tell you that there are more than 600 species of such predator or killer plants in this world. Now, you might be thinking as to how can a plant or a tree hunt other animals. Actually, these hunting plants are found at the places where they cannot get sufficient nutrients and conditioning properly. To compensate the deficit of these ingredients, these plants start hunting creatures. Every plant has its own mechanism for hunting the creatures. With the help of such mechanism, these plants are able to hunt creatures like insects, frogs, rats, squirrels, lizard, etc. So, come on, let's gather some information about a few most popular zoophagous killers and predator plants. But friends, before we proceed, I request you to please subscribe to our channel if you have not yet. And also don't forget to press the bell icon so that as soon as any video is uploaded, you get the notification. These are Nepenthes. Nepenthes is an insect-eating plant. Another name of this plant is tropical pitcher plant. It is called tropical pitcher plant because of its pitcher-like shape. This pitcher thrives in the tropical area of China, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, and India. Its shape is like a climber or tendril, but there are a few species which look like bushes. Sometimes they are called monkey cups because its shape being pitcher-like, many times monkeys come and drink water from it. Mainly these plants grow on humid or marshy places. Because of its pitcher-like shape, it is called ghatparni in Hindi. These insects-eating plants hunt not only worms but can also eat animals like frogs, rats, squirrels, lizards, etc. However, their main food is insects. Now the question arises as to how do these plants hunt? Actually, there are some glands above the pitcher-like structure which produce some liquid substance. This substance attracts the insects. Winged insects and worms land on it and they slip inside up to 8 or 9 centimeters because of greasiness. After that, they down into the liquid present inside, and that's how this plant absorbs and digests nutrients from an insect. The next one is Genericia. Mostly Genericia is found in the areas where humidity and sultriness is high. Such insect-eating plants thrive in areas which are partly aquatic. Their main habitat is Central America and Southern America. Actually, Genericia is a grass-like plant with yellow flowers. They are found with two different types of leaves, one on the ground, which can be seen easily, and another is underground, which functions as roots. These leaves absorb water. Besides, the function of these underground leaves is to lure and attract small insects. Catch them in the net and then eat them. Entering the net of this plant is very easy, but vice versa is difficult. Its leaves form an empty tube-like shape, which is snaky. Along with the flow of water, an insect enters into it, never to come out again. What comes out is only the remains of that creature. Now it is Sarracenia. Like Nepenthes, this plant also is a hunter plant which is found in the swamps of North America and Eastern America. Like Nepenthes, its constitution is goglet type. This plant produces sweet juice in the lower part of its funnel. Lured by this secretion, the insects enter into the lower part of the funnel through the upper face and fall into the liquid substance in the tube because of the glycid. There is a lid on the upper part of the funnel of this plant, which prevents rain water entering into the funnel. The liquid present inside melts down the insects. Thereafter, the nutrients like calcium and magnesium are sucked. Next is Drocera. It's a European zoophagous plant, which is also called sundews. About 130 varieties of these plants are found. Flowers of white color blossom on this plant. Leaves of the plant spread on the ground. There is a small fur on the leaves which produces some sort of liquid. In the sunlight, when this liquid is on the top of the leaves, it looks very bright and beautiful. That's why it is called sundews too. The insects take the liquid secretion from the fur present on the leaves for some juice. But it's not juice, but a glue-like sticky substance that attracts the insects. As soon as an insect lands on it, it sticks to the juice. The more it tries to free itself, the more it gets stuck into the net. Gradually, the leaves fold up to cover the insect and start digesting it. The portion that cannot be digested is dropped on the ground in the form of remains. After that, it acquires its usual shape for the next prey. A few big species of sundew eats frogs and small birds too. The next one is Darling Tonia. It is also called cobra lily or cobra plant. Mostly it is found in California. A few of its species are found in the Nilgiri of India too. It was named cobra lily because the tubular leaves of this plant have the shape like the hood of a cobra. To attract the worms and insects, this plant emits sweet smell. The upper part of the leaf is like a balloon. Just below this swollen balloon, there is a small path where the insects land only to slip into the tube. And this is Dionaea muscipula. It's a fly trap that catches flies. This is the one and only plant whose trap can be seen with naked eyes. No special device or microscope is needed to see it. Leaves of this plant look like a savage and dangerous animal or a monster. Whenever a creature lands on its leaves, they close up immediately. The leaves are so designed that the creature, once stuck, cannot free itself from the clutch. What is special about these leaves is that they can differentiate between living and non-living things. That means the leaves remain closed until an insect or any other living thing is there inside. If anything inedible gets stuck into it, the leaves reopen in less than half an hour. This behavior shows the presence of a brain in this plant because whenever an eatable creature gets stuck into it, these leaves remains closed for weeks together until the creature is dead or the plant digests the creature. These plants are found at the humid places of aquatic area on the Atlantic shore of the US. If you want to decorate your house with the plants or you are pestered with the insects and flies entering into the house, you can very well buy these plants. So, these are some zoophagous insect eating plants. We hope you liked this video, so please do press the like button and also don't forget to share it. See you in the next video with a new topic. This is your friend Neha Agarkar. Namaskar.